Hi guys, my name is Crystal May and welcome to Restorative. If you've never done Restorative before, it is a very gentle form of yoga to soften the nervous system, calm down the mind, and prepare you for a more meditative state. And so I'm really excited to teach you this class, and let's have fun. For this class, you're going to need a bolster and a block. If you don't have these props at home, even just grabbing a pillow or a rolled up blanket will work just as well, so don't worry so much about having the proper yoga props. Our first pose of the day is going to be a supported heart opener. So you're going to take your block, take it towards the top of your mat, take your bolster, and you're going to place it on top. And your spine is going to be supported by your bolster from this position. So not everybody needs a block underneath the top of your head. I just find that it's a lot more comfortable for a lot of people. If you find that you want to get rid of it at any point during the practice, just pull it out. From here, you're going to turn your back to the bolster, put as much space between you and the bottom as you feel comfortable with. And then you're going to start to lay down so that you feel supported all the way up to your skull. So now from here, you're supposed to feel like a complete surrender into this position. And so if you're having to hold yourself up, then find a more comfortable space to be in. Your knees can be bent. You can go Supta Baddha Konasana, which is just a fancy term for butterfly. Or you can start to extend the legs out nice and straight. Each pose is going to be at least a couple minutes. And so don't be shy to kind of create as much surrender as you can. And just like follow the breath. If you want to turn on some classical music or anything that you want, do what's going to make you feel more calm. From here, take a nice little deep breath in and sigh. Inhale and sigh. two more breaths here. Now from here, you're just going to start to bend into the knees again if they're not already bent. And just take a moment to kind of allow the back to release, just in case you were holding on and didn't even realize it. And then from here, you're just going to start to shift the hips towards the left and roll over towards your right side and just up and off your bolster. From here, we're going to go into a supported spinal twist. So you're going to leave the bolster exactly where it is. You're going to take the right hip and you're going to draw it towards the bottom of the bolster. Now, hands can go onto either side. You're going to walk your way down so that the chest lands onto the bolster, and you're just going to release one ear down. It doesn't matter which ear, but whatever one is more comfortable. Be mindful of your neck, and we're going to hold here for about 4 minutes. Try and surrender into the bolster. Take a deep breath in and sigh. two more breaths here. Nice and slow, you're going to start to press your way back up. Again, just leave everything exactly where it is. To switch sides, you're literally just going to rotate your knees the other way. Take left hip to the bottom of the bolster and do the exact same supported spinal twist from here. Hands come into either side and walk your way down.
slowly start to press your way back up. Okay, and you're going to unravel.
Here we're going to do alligator pose. So you're going to take your bolster towards the bottom of your mat, and this is going to go underneath the inside of your leg. So if you flip down onto your belly, and then you're going to take the right knee, bend into it, and you're going to rest the right knee, the right shin, the entire inside of the right leg from knee to ankle onto your bolster. Now you can make it as high or as low as you feel comfortable with. It's all about your range of motion and your comfort level. If you want, you can extend your left arm out, kind of like a pillow, and you're going to rest your head onto this arm.
Take two more breaths here. Okay, now take your time. You can come back down onto your belly and just release out here for a couple breaths. Sit, and then whenever you're ready to switch sides, take your time. You can switch however you feel comfortable with. We're gonna go alligator on the left. And notice the quality of thoughts that are running through your mind, and even notice the speed which your thoughts are running through. Maybe they've slowed down since your practice started. But notice even what you're allowing in. What thoughts are you choosing at this time? Take two more breaths here. Again, you can roll down onto your back or onto your belly, but you're just going to slowly come out of the pose and allow yourself just to release. And take a generous deep breath in and side out.
Last pose of the day, we're going to go into a supported Sphinx pose. So you're going to take your bolster horizontally towards the top of your mat, and this is going to lay across your chest. And so if you start to lean forward onto it, if you kind of hook your elbows around the top, and then just kind of walk your legs back, and from here you're just going to rest down into this pose. You can rest your ear down or your chin down, but just make any position you feel is comfortable.
Two more breaths here.
Okay, so from here, you're just going to push the bolster out of the way.
Release down onto your belly again. Take a couple deep breaths from here. Yeah, whenever. whenever you feel ready to move again, you're going to come up back up onto your seat.
Okay guys, to finish off our practice, we're just going to come into a couple minutes of meditation. The entire intention behind an asana practice, which are the poses that we create in yoga, is to prepare the mind and the body for meditation. And so if you've ever studied yoga, you'll know that there are 8 limbs of yoga. It's literally called Ashtanga yoga. And 4 out of the 8 limbs are forms of meditation. And so meditation is arguably the most important part of yoga. And so we're just going to spend literally 3 or 4 minutes in meditation. Take a slow deep breath in and sigh. Now the entire intention behind meditation is to learn to focus the mind. It's often described as a complete stillness of the mind, and it's less so this idea of forcing the mind into stillness and more just teaching the mind to focus. I heard this great quote one time that said, it's less about controlling the mind and more about not allowing the mind to control you. And so learn to focus the mind. Find one thing to focus on. A mantra, play ocean waves in the background, your breath. It's the most common thing people like to focus on in meditation. So find anything that you think is going to serve you, anything that will keep you focused. And anytime your mind starts to travel away, bring it back. Bring it back to the space. And it doesn't matter how many times you have to reintroduce yourself or feel like you're starting your meditation again. That's the practice of meditation. And so don't be overwhelmed when your mind decides to travel away. You have trained your mind to multitask. It is only doing what it's trained to do. So if you want it to focus, it's exactly what we do in meditation. Take a nice slow deep breath in. And sigh. Take the palms into the center of the heart. Take a slow deep breath in. And sigh. Thank you guys so much for coming to share your practice and your energy. And have a beautiful evening. Namaste.